Hello world. My name is Kasia Hewelt and I'm a data scientist at CodiLime. Today, we'll delve into the fascinating world of AI, focusing on the latest advancements in LLMs, large language models. We are going to compare CLAUDE 3, introduced by Anthropic, with well-known OpenAI's GPT-4. Our discussion will cover their capabilities, pricing, APIs, and the potential impact these developments might have on the broader AI landscape. All right, let's dive into our exploration in these advanced models. First thing first, OpenAI is widely recognized for its work in the field of AI, particularly with the development of advanced models like GPT-4. However, a new player has emerged on the scene, Anthropic. Founded by former OpenAI members, Anthropic has quickly positioned itself as a significant competitor in the AI landscape. Much like OpenAI, Anthropic is dedicated to developing general AI systems and large language models, but with a distinct focus on creating AI that is durable and aligned with human values and ethics. This focus sets it apart in a field crowded with giants like Google and newcomers like Mistral AI. Both OpenAI and Anthropic share the goal of advancing AI technology in a manner that benefits humanity, but they approach this challenge from slightly different angles, showcasing the diverse strategies with the AI research community. Let's discuss now the latest model family introduced by Anthropic. Here we have a blog post introducing the next generation of CLAUDE, CLAUDE 3. Let me gather the insights from this paper and present them to you. The previous versions of CLAUDE has been quite good, but there's a prevailing opinion that only the release of CLAUDE 3 has truly become a real competitor of GPT-4. We are talking about a model family, as three versions have been released: Haiku, Sonnet, and Opus. Each of them differs in size, price, and speed, allowing you to choose the appropriate model for a given use case. For instance, if you need fast responses and don't require complex prompts, you'd opt for a small Haiku model because it's fast and affordable. Conversely, if you have more complex tasks, you choose the larger and more expensive models. According to Anthropic's paper, each successive model offers increasingly powerful performance, allowing users to select the optimal balance of intelligence, speed, and cost for their specific application, which sounds promising. Looking at the curve, we can see that Haiku is the cheapest and, well, less intelligent than Sonnet and Opus, which grow not only in intelligence but also in price. Speaking of price, let's compare the prices of each model in the CLAUDE 3 family with GPT-4. The price comparison presented on the slide is per 1,000 tokens input and output in US dollars. We can notice that CLAUDE 3 Opus is actually the most expensive one. Another fascinating highlight from the article is the context window expansion to 200,000 tokens. This enhancement is significant, offering substantial utility. The paper mentions that all models possess the capability to process inputs exceeding 1 million tokens for certain customers requiring enhanced processing power. This advancement significantly broadens the potential application for large language models. Before, LLMs could recall the beginning and the end of prompts very well, but some of them struggle with content in the middle. Anthropic addresses this issue, claiming an impressive 99% accuracy, which marks a substantial improvement over past performances. These insights are just the tip of the iceberg. The article delves into several other features, including the reduction of incorrect refusals, enhancements in accuracy, and benchmark comparisons, among other LLMs. If you're intrigued, I encourage you to explore it further. The article is linked in the video description below. Let's explore Anthropic together. After creating the account, you get the first $5 free to use. In the dashboard, you can explore a couple of functionalities. Let's go first to get API keys, as we eventually have to do this. Okay, to create an API key, we simply click create key, name the key, and that's it. We can also track our usage, track our plans and billings. As you can see, I still have some free balance to use, even though I built a small POC and I've been testing Claude a lot. And we can track our usage. I've been using Haiku, Opus and Sonnet, all three version. Even though Haiku was published a few days ago, you can now work with it. Now that we are familiar with that, let's just start prompting and test the models. You can either go back to dashboard and click start prompting with Claude, or go directly to Workbench. The UI is pretty friendly. On the left panel, you can check the history here. I like the fact that it's hidden and you can give a name to your chat. On this panel, you can also select the model you want to work with. And we can also adjust the temperature or max token sample. What is also very interesting here is that we can put a system prompt. What is a system prompt? It is an initial set of instructions that serve as the starting point when starting a new chat session. This defines things for the chat and helps to focus its capabilities. It is a good place to define the role or roles, like you are a sales assistant, focus on this and that while giving me the output. You can also give some guidelines to verify your output. And then we have the chat window where we can start posing questions. Let's put our Claude to the test and ask some sample questions like, what are the top 5 tourist attractions in Paris? We hit the run button on the right and there we get the output. Here are the top 5 tourist attractions in Paris, Eiffel Tower, of course, Louvre, Notre Dame, etc. Let's put it into the test with reasoning. All right, we can add it to our conversation here and pose another question. Mike is taller than Jane, Jane is taller than Chris. Is Mike taller than Chris? Let's see what the chat responds. Yes, Mike is taller than Chris, which is correct. We even have the whole chain of thoughts. In fact, I compared that last question with GPT-4 Turbo in a tool called LLMs. You can have a look in chatbot arena. You can put the model of your choice and compare the prompt between those two models. And as you can see, GPT-4 also responded yes, if Mike is taller than Jane and Jane is taller than Chris, then Mike is taller than Chris. You can see the difference in the output between those two models. As I already mentioned, the Claude model gave us the whole chain of thought. However, I put the Claude Sonnet here into the test and we were just using Claude Opus in the given example. Claude is giving us one more very interesting feature, which is get code just right here on the right. We can just click, choose our language between Python, TypeScript, AWS, Bedrock Python and TypeScript, and just copy the code with API connection. Okay, let's explore the APIs. In this segment, we look at coding with OpenAI and Anthropic APIs. Even though Anthropic joined the game later, they made their API similar to OpenAI's, which is great, in my opinion, because AI engineers who know how to use OpenAI won't have to learn everything from scratch to use Anthropic. It saves time and makes things just easier. This move by Anthropic is more than just convenient. It also encourages more innovation and creativity in AI development. As we go through examples, notice how similar they are in how to call them, what you put in, and what you get back. We'll compare these by using them to write some summaries. At CodiLime, we have a blog on our website where we share knowledge across various IT sectors, including data science, networks, UX, software development, and more. Today, we will challenge two models to summarize an article about a crucial step in data preparation: data wrangling. Let's see how these models perform in providing a summary and the top 10 keywords, all by just supplying the link without scrapping any content. Let's discuss and examine now a Python code snippet designed to utilize the OpenAI and Anthropic APIs, aim at summarizing content and identifying the top 10 keywords from an article provided via a URL link. First, ensure that you have obtained the API keys for both OpenAI and Anthropic. Then we begin by importing the necessary libraries, followed by initializing client objects to manage our request to API. Our main function, summarize and get keywords, now takes a URL link as an input. It constructs a prompt for OpenAI's GPT-4 model and Anthropic CLAUDE. Specifically, we are testing now the Sonnet version, that was the middle one. This request is configured with settings to manage the response length and cost at the same time, including setting a token limit and ensuring more deterministic responses by setting the temperature parameter to zero. The responses from the APIs are processed to extract and generate summary and keywords, which are then returned. To improve visibility, I've incorporated the Streamlit code to display the results. For these who are not familiar with this library, Streamlit is an open source Python library that simplifies the process of creating and sharing beautiful custom web apps for machine learning and data science projects. Let me show you how it works. And this is our app. This is how the app looks like: URL summarizer and keyword extractor. Simply by pasting the URL link to our article about data wrangling I mentioned before, and hitting the button summarize, we'll get the summary and the top 10 keywords for both Anthropic and OpenAI. As we can see, Anthropic results came first, which means this model is faster. We got the summary, which looks good, and the top 10 keywords. As you can see, some keywords are overlapping, of course in the different order because they are two different language models, but in general everything looks okay. Let's summarize this experience. Both CLAUDE 3 and GPT-4 represent an exciting progress in the realm of AI language models. The observed slight speed advantage of the Sonnet model over GPT-4 highlights the importance of considering various attributes such as speed, cost, efficiency when integrating these technologies into AI-driven applications. As the landscape of AI continues to evolve rapidly, it becomes very challenging to stay up to date with the latest developments. Looking ahead, the ability to swiftly adapt and incorporate new technologies will be crucial, demanding a careful balance of the factors like cost, speed, performance, and the intelligence of the models to tailor solutions to the specific use cases. Let me know if you have any questions. Thank you.